The UK recently spent a whole week without burning coal. That's great news. But it's not the final goal yet, just another step in the right direction. Other steps should include not burning coal at all, not burning oil and gas anymore, and every other country in the world not burning fossil fuels anymore. But this won't be easy, since the energy demand of the world is increasing and will increase over the next decades for several reasons. Our population is growing. The standard of living of billions of people is increasing. And more parts of our lives become electrified. Just think about transportation, which used to be dominated by combustion engines, but is now shifting toward electric mobility. To get rid of fossil fuels, we have to consider renewable energies, like wind and solar power. But they got one big disadvantage. They don't necessarily produce the energy when we need it. Think about solar power. On a sunny day, we might actually produce more energy than we need. Yeah, maybe not in the UK, but you get the gist of it. But at night, there's no sun at all, but we still have some energy demand. So we need a way to store the excess energy from the day to use it at night, or to store the energy from a windy season to use in a calm season. Unfortunately, electricity is kind of energy that doesn't like to be stored. We have batteries for that, but they get disadvantages like being very big and heavy compared to the amount of energy they can store. And they discharge over time. And you need a lot of resources to build them. One of them is lithium, which we are already running short of. That's why almost all field of science is trying to come up with solutions on how to store energy in other ways than electricity. And here's one of geology's contributions. Good evening. Welcome again to Cooking with Rocks. Glad you made it here again after yesterday's pilot episode. Today we're making a well-done compressed air energy storage. And we're going to need a huge underground salt formation, water, a pump, and a turbine. First, we drill a hole into our salt formation and pump water inside, which then dissolves a cavity that has about this shape, but 60 meters in diameter. Then we close our borehole and install a pump and a turbine there. Then, whenever there's excess energy, we pump air inside to a pressure of up to 70 bar. And when we need energy, we release it through the turbine. To be honest, that's not the whole story yet. There's some thermodynamics involved as well, but 3 minutes. But I can tell you that a couple of compressed air energy storages have been in service for decades now, showing great results, and no signs of geological risks. So maybe we will see more of them in the future. Or maybe we won't, since they're underground, which makes them even cooler. Thank you.